Back to my channel. It's been a while, right? It has been a while, and that's because I have been, reevaluating things and just, making sure things are aligned properly, making sure that, everything, my message, everything I bring to you, it's according to plan and according to purpose, not just coming up and posting anything. So I've had a moment, when I say a moment, I've had a moment to think, a moment to reflect on my messaging. What am I, putting up out there? How is it impacting you and all of that? So normally, what I usually post things on women, So women, topics relating to women, how to help women, how to empower women. Okay. However, that's going to change slightly, slightly, not too much, slightly. Women, I'm not leaving you. You are still involved. Okay. So I have listened. Women often say, "Oh, Glory, what you are saying is so true, is impactful, and is helping." And I'm happy. I'm always pleased to get, excuse me, that type of feedback. However, they say, when they go home, they are going back to the same situation. They are going back to, they have been changed and all of that. What about their partner? What about their spouses? They want people to not only talk to women, they want people to talk to men as well. They want everyone to be involved. That way, people, whole, they will be whole, wholesome, not only one person all the time. And I reasoned and I thought to myself, that's true. Also, last year, I had two people, important people in my life, say, what you are doing is very, because I have conferences, women's conferences as well, and things like that. And they're like, this is very good. Who else do you think your message is appropriate for? I said, well, right now I'm only focused on the women. I know this message, can help others, but at the moment I'm focusing on the women. I had that conversation with this lady, and then a few months later, another person came to me and said, Glory, who do you think your message would help? Who else apart from women? And I knew where they were going. Apart from these two people, I've had this, prompting and, the nudging to think, who else? Who else? Anyway, I have listened to everyone. I've listened. I've taken a moment to think about it. If you notice, I haven't posted for like a month now because I need to be true to myself, not just because people or somebody's saying this or that. I've, taken the time out, and I know I have been getting the promptings myself, but I just thought, focus on the women for now. Let's keep working and, improving things and all of that. However, from now on, as a coach, I'm going to be coaching families and relationships. So my coaching is going to be focused on families and relationships. How do we ensure we have a healthy relationship? It's good for us all individually to be healthy, but it doesn't help when we go back into situations that are not helping, hostile environments and all of that, strife and things like that. What about the case, situation where the couple or the family can together go out and listen to messages, go to events together and be blessed as one unit, be blessed as one family? That way they go back home, they have time to think about the message and say, wow, how do we apply this into our home? How can we practice this? How can we make our home a better place? So my coaching is now going to be focused on issues around family and relationships, ensuring we are healthy. The society is made up of small units, and these units are the families. Okay, we, the family unit, make up the society, the larger society. So if each family unit is healthy, imagine what our society will be like. You know, so focusing on this family, it's essential, it's crucial for healthy relationships. Relationships, you know, not only as a couple, we have relationships between husband and wife, relationship between siblings, relationship in the workplace, and all of that. How do you ensure your relationships are healthy? So we are going to be talking about different topics, emotional intelligence, and a whole lot more. So I thought to come here today to, you know, inform us, to bring us on board, because you are my family, you watch my YouTube channel and all of that. I'm sure you've been wondering why I haven't posted for some time, where's Glory and all of that. Glory is here. She's been working hard behind the scenes to bring you the best, to bring you everything you need to ensure that you prosper, not only on your own as an individual, but to ensure you have a healthy environment around you. Children are healthy, your marriage is healthy. You know, marriages are going through a lot right now due to the COVID-19 lockdown. So many things happened behind closed doors for lots of couples. You know, so many people have been challenged and all of that. We understand that that's, you know, something a lot of people have had to go through. Some marriages have even broken down as a result. What if I was to tell you that there is another way? There's another way. Instead of the marriage breaking down, you can nurture it and grow together. So as a family coach and relationship coach, this is why I'm here. This is what I'm here to help you with. Okay? Get in touch if things are going south, not as you have planned, not what you dreamed of. There's a way, there's another way out. There's a solution. There's an adage that says, when all doors are locked, there's always a window somewhere open. You may not have seen it. Somebody else looking, watching, observing may have seen that window. So I'm calling on you to take that opportunity. That window is open. Don't give up yet. Don't say, look, I've had enough. Do you believe that things can be healed? Do you believe that brokenness can be made whole again? So if you are watching this, you are listening, and you're at that point where you're thinking, look, I'm giving up. I'm saying, before you give up, why don't you give it one more chance? One more chance is what I'm asking you for. Don't give up. There's nothing like giving up. One more chance. Let's have a chat. I often give 30 minutes free consultation. Why don't you send me a message, DM me, private message me, and say, hey, Glory, I would like us to have a chat about my relationship, about my marriage. You know, I have given up. Is there hope? What can I do? What can we do? Let's give it one more chance, and then you can make up your mind afterwards. All right? So that's what I do as a coach, and I'm so happy. I'm happy to be in this space. I'm glad to be here, and I'm looking forward to chatting with as many of you. Let's be healthy. Let's be whole together. Okay? So that's me. That's my message for today. If you have enjoyed listening to me, do subscribe, okay? I'm going to be playing a little clip after this. Take a moment, watch it. It's about purpose and all of that, you know, for you as an individual, okay? Take it, watch it. In a family, are you working and saying, I'm only going to work on my own purpose? Have you thought about the purpose of your unit, your family? Okay, what's your role as a woman? What's your role as a man? What's the role of the children? Have you taken time to discover each person's purpose and why you are together as a family? Take a moment. Don't give up yet. Take a moment. Think about this. Give me a chat. call me, okay, or send me a message. You can also go to my website. It is www.gloriousglowempowerment.com. Send me a message that way. I look forward to hearing from you. So take a moment, watch the clip attached after this. Take care now, whatever you do, stay blessed. Bye.
Something very important that I think is important to everyone, which is about our purpose. You know, sometimes we think we have all the time to fulfill all our purpose. We have all the time to live our dreams, right? We have all the time to fulfill our passions and things like that. However, nobody actually knows when their time is up. Or do you know when your time is up on earth? Definitely not. No one knows when their time is up. So what is stopping you from actually fulfilling your dreams? What's stopping you from fulfilling your passions? Are you looking at other people and saying, oh, what would they say? You know, what would people say? What would people think? Are you living your life by people's opinion? Or are you just going to go out there and live your dreams? What is that desire? What is that deep thing, that passion you have within you that you feel you really would love to do or achieve? But for some reason, maybe culture, your cultural heritage, or by culture, I'm a woman, I'm not meant to do this, excuse me, I can't do this, I can't do that because I'm a woman, excuse me, my phone is about to go off, you know. Or you feel your religion, what's your religion? You know, why is it holding you back? You know, or you're thinking about society. Oh, in my society where I come from, you know, this is not allowed or that's not allowed. If you do this or that, it will be frowned upon. So for that reason, you feel, no, I'll leave it, you know, I'll leave it for another time.